Hey friends, I am back with another Breaking Down the Score. Holy shit. We're gonna do Thank Goodness from Wicked. Now, this one's a little rhythmically more challenging than most. So it starts at the end of Act 2 opening. Then we have... So it's in 5, 1, 2, 3, 2, 2, 1, 2, 3, da, da, 1, 2, 3, da, da. So the first beat of it is a triplet, and then the last one is 2/8. So that's how I would count this. It would be 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 1, 2. It's like a 6/8 bar without the last eighth note. And it kind of fits with what's going on story-wise in the show at this point. Glinda comes back, and they're celebrating, but... when something's in 5, it usually doesn't feel, at least in this context, it doesn't feel like it sits comfortably. It feels uncomfortable rhythmically. Because it's in 5, it doesn't line up, which gives conflict and tension to the character in the moment. Oh, well, what a celebration we'll have today. Thank goodness. There's dialogue here. This is like the hook of the song. So we just had the verse with the celebration part. Now we have the chorus of the song. We couldn't be happier, right dear, couldn't be happier. It's like when somebody's trying to validate you, you feel crazy on the inside. It's like, oh yeah, this is right, right? This is right, right dear? This is okay. Like I'm doing the right thing. I feel right in myself. And you're kidding yourself, but you really don't feel right. It's like you're loopy. That's what's happening to Glinda right now. We couldn't be happier, right dear? Like, I need validation for you to say yes, that's okay. Couldn't be happier, right here, look what we got, a fairy tale plot, our very own happy ending. Right, and it's not a fairy tale happy ending. So what she's saying doesn't match what she's feeling at this moment. Couldn't be happier, and we're happy to share. Now we finally get a 6/8, which is like, oh, thank God. It's something that you don't have to really fucking count. It just feels right. The day you were first summoned to an audience with us. She goes on. It's a little darker now. We're in F sharp minor. Gives it a new color. Then with a jealous squeal, the wicked witch was from concealment. So now these words don't, the rhyme is not symmetrical, which I like. I like that. Stephen Schwartz does this. I hear she has an extra eye that always remains awake. So now we're back into this weird 5 pattern. This is where we have that wicked theme just stitched into that 5/8. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. No one mourns a wicked. Right there at bar 100. And then it does it again. Now at 1/13, we have the popular theme, but it's not set in 2, okay? He's playing with the rhythm a bit here. Popular. Reassuring here with Glinda. Now we go back into that weird 5/8. So now we're in major here. So now part 3, she's saying how she was really feeling. I couldn't be happier, though it is, I admit, the tiniest bit unlike I anticipated. So she didn't anticipate this. So now we know why it's in 5. But I couldn't be happier, simply couldn't be happier. In your dreams is strange, but it seems a little, well, complicated. See, it's complicated. Like the rhythm! I'm gonna keep coming back to that. Because happy is what happens when all your dreams come true. Well, now it's a deceptive cadence. Okay, so a deceptive cadence, something that's deceptive. It fools you, right? So in the music, you would think, all your dreams come true, which would be just a regular cadence. Okay. Deceptive gives you something that doesn't feel like home yet. You know, all your dreams come true. It doesn't land home. If it ended there, it'd be like, what's happening? All your dreams come true. Well, and it goes into For All This Joy, and then all the townspeople sing, and it's wonderful. Fiance, right? She's still not convinced. See, because she asks a question again at bar 58 in part three. All your dreams come true. Well, isn't it? Happy is what happens when your dreams come true. And that's not true. She doesn't know that yet. She's trying to convince herself. And then we go into the ending here. And then she sings, I couldn't be happier today. And that's the Kristen Chenoweth note because she could hit it. Anyway, so that's Thank Goodness. I hope you enjoyed this breaking down a score, and I will talk to you soon. Bye!